Hello everyone, my name is PJ, and welcome back to my Let's Play of Ape Escape Part 5. You'll notice I'm not standing where I said I would be standing. Yeah, I'll get to that in a second. Yep. If you're wondering where yesterday's video was, I did tell you all earlier that I take one weekend off each week. So, that's why there was no video. But yesterday, my friend Tyler came over, and he really took a look at this emulator and tried to fix my joystick problem. He tried more stuff than I did, and still couldn't come up with a solution. Although, we did learn something interesting. If you switch which joystick does what in the emulator, you still get the same issues. So, it's not the ROM. It's apparently the controller. But I tried a different controller before, and the same thing happened. I don't know. There's no explanation for this. But I'm gonna be getting that monkey in the cage, because I forgot about this. Yeah, you come down here, and this is the hole that you can rise up through. Easy, right? And you stand on this, get the super hoop, and dash out. Up. Okay. Yeah, I think it can actually go through that cage door as long as it's not closed. I know that sounds obvious, but I mean, like, actually phase through the door itself while it's in the middle of closing. Now, are there any other monkeys left here? I know there's one in that big computer box thingy up above. But I'll worry about getting the last monkeys later. We'll have to come back to this stage eventually anyway. Yep, so, back up here. We're about to fight the first actual boss of this game. There's only 4 actual bosses in this whole game. That sounds like a low number. And it is, but I want to say we're about halfway done with the game right now. It's a long time to reach the first boss. Alright, here we go.
Well, look who's here. So you finally found us.
Spectre. Jake.
And how is everything coming along?
Everything is under control and coming along very nicely, according to plan.
Very good. Then let's get going.
Right.
Hold on! You're not going anywhere!
Oh, yes, we are. I don't have time to bother with you right now. Oh, but we will. We will meet again. You just wait. You won't even know what hit you.
Another time, another place. You'll have your chance.
See, that ship kinda interests me, because it's like, that thing has the ability to travel through time. So, is it part of the time station? Yeah, then you get this fight, with this weird knight guy. You gotta keep an eye on him, wait for him to swing, and then hit him. He acts exactly like that knight from below. Oh, come on. Oh, what? Oh dear. I seem to have encountered a slight bug. I think left isn't working now either. Oh, come on, the shockwave hit me? Oh, cookie. Where'd that come from? No, I think it's still just up. Ah, come on! Yeah, as long as he's not electrocharged like that, you can hit him once. But he's not so hard. And he's dead. Look at that. How many times I hit him? Like 4? 5?
Yes.
And then something unusual happens. You miss it if you skip these cutscenes. No Natalie. No Professor. And then
hey, wait a minute. What's going on here?
And then we get to hear Casey talk.
Spike, listen, I have a message from the professor.
Let's hear it.
Understood.
Spike, I'm sure you've seen the strange things going on outside. While you were gone, Spectre and his gang of apes swept in and have taken over the town. The entire town is running scared. Everything's been turned upside down. It's a mess and we need your help. Here, take a look. Spectre's built his base right in the middle of town. The apes are everywhere. His army is getting stronger and more dangerous. You're the only one who can save us all. You've got the gadgets, now go use them. Time is running out. We're counting on you.
Ah, hey, wait a minute, what are you doing?
Hold on.
Let go of me!
Yep, so right away, the whole game drops the whole traveling through time theme. It's gone. We're going to be in the present for the rest of the game. Except for one other level. And when we go back to catch all the other monkeys. But yeah, that didn't last long, did it? And none of the other games deal with time travel. Wow, they got bored fast, huh? There were so many other time periods they could have, you know, focused on, but they didn't. Futurama. Now, I should mention, this game came out the exact same year as the Futurama cartoon. Coincidence? City Park.
I've just finished evaluating the new gadget for the professor, and we've sent it over to you. You'll find it in the training room. As the professor's already told you, if you don't complete the training, you can't advance to the next area. Good luck!
I was contemplating the other day that maybe I should have drawn Casey for the thumbnail art instead, because despite how few lines she gets, she's still way more interesting than Natalie. Anyway, this is the RC car. One of the most annoying to use gadgets in the entire series. You hit R3 to summon it, and then you can drive it around with the joystick. You hit enemies with it, kills them right away. I know all this shit, come on, stupid mailbox. Yeah. It's pretty powerful, actually. You can leave it sitting on buttons, so you can just walk through doors. Don't even need the super hoop. And there are a lot of these little gaps everywhere that we'll be seeing, both in the past and present, that you can drive the RC car through. Yeah, they'll be expecting you to use the RC car a lot in these last few levels.
Spike, something has gone terribly wrong. The professor and Natalie are nowhere to be found. The laboratory has been ransacked and much of the equipment has been destroyed. The apes were here, and I believe they've taken the professor and Natalie away with them. You're now being transported to Spectre's base area. His exact location is unknown. All I can tell you at this time is that his base is an old factory building located in the middle of town somewhere. Spectre's taken it over and is now using it to manufacture weapons. But first, before you head over to the base, find the energy storehouse. The energy storehouse is the heart of Spectre's factory. By destroying this, you'll shut down all the power to his base. The energy storehouse is hidden somewhere within a nearby park. Please hurry! The Professor and Natalie may be in great danger. One more thing. The base has a heavy and very powerful security system that will not be affected by the power shutdown. So be careful.
Now that little spiel right there doesn't make a whole lot of sense. Because according to Casey, this first level we're going to has a powerhouse of sorts that we're supposed to destroy. However, that's not our objective. Our objective is to catch 8 monkeys.
Let's go!
I don't even know if we see anything like a powerhouse in this level. But... And another thing, if the point of destroying the powerhouse... What is the point of destroying the powerhouse, that is to say? Because if it doesn't affect the security system, then why bother? Come on, chase the monkey out, and then catch it. I said catch it. There we go. See, right away, it just kind of tells you, use the race car. What's that say? I think that says kids, or rids. I don't know. Yeah, but if Spectre's apes were perfectly capable of taking over the present, why did they bother going back in time? That whole time traveling business was just kind of skimmed over. Frickin' bees? Jeez. Anyway, there's an ape in here who likes the box. Ah, see? Come on, get out of there. Yeah, I never showed that off. If you just hold the net out like this, any monkeys that walk into it will get caught. It doesn't make any physical sense, and they fixed that bug in the sequels. Well, maybe they fixed it in the remake. I don't know. I never played it because I can't stand the changes they made to it, namely the new voices. Anyway, there is a huge ass. Ah, jeez! Oh, I thought the monkey would get in it. Never mind. Yeah, but this robot isn't actually all that tough. He has one slow projectile attack, and the only other thing he can do is swing that hammer around. As long as you keep swinging at him, he can't really hit you. Unless your joystick screws up like mine. Come on. And it's destroyed. And you get an extra life. Now you probably heard a machine gun. That's the monkey up there. There's no way to get up there from here. So he's one of the last monkeys we'll get. I think maybe you can shoot him down. I think I've tried to do that before. No, he doesn't drop down. Oh well. Anyway, we are done outside. That should be all the monkeys we need to open. Yeah, that we saw the cutscene that opened this hatch. And down we go. Yeah, look at that graffiti. Kids. Oh yeah, kids. They're so rebellious, right? Anyway, let's see. There's nothing in this pool at all. What the hell is even the point? I guess just to tell you right away that you're in the sewers. It's kind of obvious, though. Now, these things. Clearly, they didn't go extinct after all these millennia. Oh, cookies. Come here, you. Fucking missiles. Stay away from me. Alright. This level makes a lot of use out of the RC car. So, let's summon it. Get it under there. Sneak up on you. No sneezing. Easy. And I get all my health back. Now let's summon the RC car again. Chase you out. Oh, also, if the monkeys want, they can attack the RC car and blow it up. Which will knock them out if they get caught in the explosion, but you don't want that because then you just have to summon it again. Oh, come on! Come on. Get out. Oh my god, get out! No, you don't. Okay. Oh, whoops. Never mind. I thought there was something more to these stairs, but I guess not. Now we have a choice. We can go through that tunnel right there, or we can keep going right. Well, first, I think there's something down here. Oh, it's just a large energy chip. Typically, wherever there's a good place for a Spectacoin to be, there's a large energy chip instead. Now, this slope... obviously, can't walk on the slope. So, let's summon the RC car. It can drive up the slope just fine. I guess it's because its tires got traction or something. We gotta get it in the hole. There we go. And make it stand on that button. Come on. And boom. Come here. You noticed me, don't you? Jeez. Okay. Let's see. Now, this platform that I'm standing on right now, this rusted part, that button on the left will make it drop out from underneath me. Get the cookies. There we go. Now, this is the first of many difficult parts where you have to carefully drive the RC car over a thin pathway. If it falls off, you gotta start all over. And there we go. That monkey that was shooting missiles at us before? Fuck him. I don't know why I did that. I need the RC car again. Alright, only two monkeys to go. This next area will require the Sky Flyer. Like, a lot. Now, this area drives a lot of people insane. Because that slope there, you will slide down it, but you are capable of repeatedly jumping while you're on it. And then there are these huge barrels of differing sizes. Blue barrels are the largest, green barrels are the smallest, and red barrels are in the middle. But you have to jump on top of them, which can be a pain in the ass, and use them to get around. Without letting them push you. Now, let's see. Come on. There we go. Oh, come on. Hit it! Now, where'd that monkey go? Ah, there you are. Easy. And there's an underwater pathway over there, which I'm about to go do. But I gotta go up air first. Come on. That monkey that we just saw up above in the cage, that's who we're gonna get next. Or not. I guess I'll grab this one instead. I didn't know that one was there. Forgot about that one. Oh well. I really wish it would let you catch as many monkeys as you wanted before the level ended. And of course, there's no point in watching those scenes until we've rescued Natalie and the professor. I should save. The next level we're going to is the weapons factory. And there are a lot of difficult enemies there. That giant robot we fought in the beginning of the previous level, there's gonna be more of them in different varieties. Oh wow, I'm doing pretty good. How did I get up to 6 lives? Spectre's Factory. Now, according to Casey, apparently we just destroyed the powerhouse. Just from completing that city park level. And now that we've done so, the power is out here at the factory. And the only thing still online is the security system. Now, these things are pretty cool. Tanks that, using the joysticks, actually drive around like tanks and can destroy pretty much anything. Like those fuckers. Fuck you, fuck you, fuck these flashing walls. They're pretty cool. The way they work, you hold in both joysticks up to go forward, both joysticks back to go backward, just the left joystick up to go right, and just the right joystick up to go back, left. I doubt it, but can I sneak up on that monkey? Come on. Oh yeah, jump to get out. Oh. Nope, okay. It's programmed to automatically notice you when you get close. I figured as much. This could take me a while. There we go. No more UFO for you. Now I just gotta catch you. Not so bad. It takes a while, but... yeah, and this tank? Even though it's literally up in flames, it's still good. One more hit will destroy it, but then we can just go back and get another one. You don't gotta worry about getting stuck. Come on. There we go. All those troubles you gave me before in previous levels. Yeah, fuck you. Come on, give me cookies. Like Geno's Forest. I don't need to destroy this wall, but I want to. Because this thing is awesome. Anyway, moving on. Some more of these things. Come on. There we go. Now that's another monkey that will automatically notice me as soon as I get close. And he'll destroy my tank, and I'll have to go back and get another one. No. Yeah. Okay, I figured as much. Now, if I just... Can I actually kill this thing without the tank? No, I can't hurt it at all. And my stun club just bounces right off. Alright, let's go back and get it. And that takes care of that. But this is only the beginning of the factory. That's some loud electricity. Jeez. Let's take a look around. They're producing more Peak Point helmets. Which, in all the sequels, were called Peepo helmets, because Peepo is the Japanese sound effect for the sound of a siren. I think Peak Point helmet sounds much cooler. Anyway, can't go through that door, another monkey. Now we have two choices. We can go through that door, or we can go over there and hit this wheel a bunch. Oh, right, it doesn't matter. Because this wheel just lowers that drawbridge, which we can't even get up to right now. We would need to first lower this platform. And I think we can't do that without going through that monkey gate. So, gotta go this way first. Okay, that monkey is our next goal. We gotta catch it to open that door. So, this whole room is one big RC car maze. You gotta follow it all throughout and make sure it doesn't get destroyed. Careful not to hit R3 or you'll have to start all over. You'll summon the RC car to your position. Feel free to take this part slow, because it's pretty stressful. Alright, and then you get a checkpoint. Because here, you can summon the RC car again. But this part's a little life and death. So you want to make sure that you, you know, pay attention. And drive the RC car to the next button. Grab this Spectre coin here. I died and I didn't even get the Spectre coin. Now I gotta start the whole room over. Now, there is an easy way to do that part. The easiest way is to just remove the RC car from the button and put it back on. I think that resets the platform. Okay, I'm back to this part. Let's try this again. Gotcha. Okay. Now I can catch that monkey up here. Hopefully, without it noticing me. Because this one's got missiles, and I hate missiles. Unless I'm the one firing them. Gotcha. Okay, now that monkey gate is open. Now I gotta go find the switch that will raise that platform. Okay, this part wants to look like it's dangerous, but it's really not. It's only dangerous if you try to go after all the energy chips. Just stand on this platform and it will move forward. Then you just walk right and left. Easy. Now this room, a lot of people have trouble with this room, but it's not all that hard. How it works is, you've got three platforms over there, and they're labeled 1, 2, and 3 that you can raise using these wheels. How you're supposed to do it is you're supposed to raise each one just one at a time in a row. Get the Sky Flyer out, that'll help. Now, raise this one all the way up, walk over to the next one, raise it all the way up, walk over to the next one, raise this all the way up, and then without hitting any more cogs, run over to this one and start climbing. And you'll get up just fine. Extra life there. Alright, now we gotta make sure not to get hit by these mallets. If we get hit by these mallets, I gotta do that over again. And I'll probably die, because there's no platform down there and the lava will likely kill me. And I love this part because it forces the camera to be diagonal. So I don't have to worry about the joystick glitch. Okay, let's do it. Yoink. Yoink. No! Well, at least I got knocked forward. Okay. Come on, get it. There we go. Let me take out that drone. Good. Okay. You'll probably notice where we are. Yeah, that's that drawbridge that the wheel below opens. And this is the switch that lowers the platform. Gotcha. Alright, and that makes a shortcut. Now we can come down to here. Lower the drawbridge, wait until that platform is closer to our level, hop over, and then get up it. Oh no, really? Wow. That's a bit more time sensitive than I thought. Come here. There we go. That was much better. Alright. Notice they give you a whole bunch of cookies right here. Time for a mini boss. Immediately jump on this box. I can't. Oh, it grabbed me. Okay. That's fine. It's fine, I guess. Jump up here. Wait for it to charge into you, and then hit it in the back. Jump when it charges, hit it in the back. Come on, there we go, frickin' joysticks. Jump on a box, wait for it to charge, jump over it, hit it in the back. No more boxes? That's fine. Just start using the Sky Flyer. Yeah. easy. Alright, two monkeys to go. Let me go grab those other cookies. Yeah, but we didn't get the robot to destroy this last wall here. That's fine, you can just jump behind him. God damn these things. I wait for the spikes to go away, and then wiggle, and then jump, and then go, and then no. Okay. God, I hate those things. Don't. Yeah, if you were wondering what happens if you're in lava, that happens. Very similar to what happens in Bugs Bunny Lost in Time if you fall in lava. You just get propelled into the air. Now, the game wants you to immediately turn that cog in order to, you know, progress. But there's stuff down below. First, let's take out these drones. Which effectively act exactly the same as those flying dragon thingies in previous levels. Or those helicopter thingies in the oriental themed levels. Now this monkey over here is kind of annoying to deal with, because first you gotta scale it out of its cage, but you'll notice it's wearing dark blue pants. It's really fast, so if you don't catch it the instant you scale it out of the cage, yeah, see, blew up the car. Get out of there. Oh, God damn it. God, you are too fast. Fucking Sonic the Ape. Are you kidding? The net was right on him. Now I gotta chase after him. Gotcha. Anyway, that wall, can't get through it without the last gadget. So, let's turn this. It lowers this big old pipe, which you can jump into. But, instead of going straight forward, wait. Let it continue taking you up. Spectre coin up there. And if you turn around, there's stuff up here. Namely, a monkey. Oh, no. No sneezing!
Yes!
Okay, then I'm gonna save again because all of these last levels are pretty big and difficult. Okay, last level of the Futurama section. Yeah, you notice how the camera just zooms up. TV tower. Not to scale. Go catch Spectre. Now it's rather interesting that the TV tower is one of the levels in this game where you're told to go catch Spectre. Because Ape Escape 3 is all about TV and movie genres. Anyway, outside the tower, if you immediately go over to... Was it the left? Yeah, hold on. On the left, you find another one of these weird computer box thingies. You can hear the monkey inside of it. But can't do anything about that yet. You go inside, and right away, there's more new enemies. But these things act exactly the same as the drones. Only instead of going in circles, they just kind of go left to right. There's a monkey right there. Gotta sneak up on him. Yeah, pretty much every monkey in these last levels is armed too. No more nice guys. Get back here. Okay, and there should also be a monkey. Never mind. I thought there was like a reception desk somewhere. But I think that corner where I first found him is supposed to be that. Anyway, you'll notice this weird pool here. What the hell was that? Did it come from up there? Whatever. Anyway, you'll notice this weird pool here in the main lobby of the TV tower for some reason. It's not even barred off, so just about anyone visiting could fall in. But we need to drain this pool because that will open a door up at the bottom. So, first go through these automatic doors. These things barely do anything. Hello? Did you come out of your hiding hole? No!
Oh no!
Those missiles are really hard to dodge. It's not my fault, it's like that monkey came after me. He's not supposed to be right there. He's supposed to be all the way at the edge of this tunnel. He just kind of wandered over here. Yeah, see? He starts over here. God damn it! How did you spot me? Fucking homing missiles! Too smart for their own goddamn good. Anyway, this button over here drains the water. Somehow, the button in the back of the fan drains the pool. Why is it so dark? Has it been that dark this whole time? It was plenty bright when I started recording. Weird. Anyway, going down the pool is actually the wrong way. But I want to get as many monkeys as possible during my first visit. Let's see. Extra life. And those things are so easy to deal with. Now let's see. I'm pretty sure there was something to do. Yeah, there's a rowboat there, and those things in the water are kinda dangerous. Ah, there's a monkey over there. I'm gonna get the drop on him. Yeah. How did you fucking see me? Fine. Just make yourself easier to catch, why don't you? That opened up the monkey gate up above. I guess technically this isn't the wrong way. Because you did have to catch at least one more monkey in order to progress. Forgot there was a monkey gate up there. Okay, now this one, gotta shoot it down. Now, I could have sworn there was more to this place. Like, more basement. Am I thinking of a different level? I might be thinking of the level after this one. There's a level with a giant fan. It's probably the level after this one. Maybe. Okay. Enter the elevator. And who knows how many floors up the elevator just took us. Look at this place. It's enormous. What is this place even for? Is this supposed to be a set? It's ridiculous. But yeah, you get into this tank here. And then you drive it along this kinda thin walkway. People tend to fall off. Not because the walkway is thin or difficult or anything, but just because most people aren't used to tank controls. Speaking of tank controls, Tomb Raider's controls aren't half as bad as people say they are. Once you've learned them, they are very in-depth. And I should totally play the Tomb Raider games at some... No! Why is it that every time I say something is easy, or intuitive, or any kind of good, anytime I compliment anyone else, or just compliment myself, it's always, nope, we gotta prove PJ wrong. We can't have him being right about things. But that's fine. Gotta bring the tank down here anyway to destroy all these crates. There's monkeys hiding in them. Energy chip here. Monkey. No sneezing! And you can see that monkey through that one crate over there. Let's go pay him a visit. Dark again. What the hell? It seems to get darker with time. What's going on? Is it the sunlight in my room? maybe. I don't have anything that covers the windows. Spectacoin. How close am I to 40? Because the last minigame, the one that requires a whopping 40 Spectacoins to unlock, is doubtlessly the best of the three minigames. It's called Galaxy Monkey. I mean, that is still a matter of opinion, of course, but I always liked it the most. Yeah, it's fitting that it's the most expensive. Now, to get back up, you just pop yourself into this elevator here, and you start driving on the pathway all over again, being careful not to fall off like a douche nozzle. There we go. And then when we hit this button here, oh yeah, L3 shoots a machine gun. Not as useful as just shooting the cannon with R3. Yeah, see? Can't even activate a cookie jar with it. But now that we've activated this elevator, we've got ourselves another shortcut. And that elevator over there is what will take us to the end of the stage. But we're not done here yet. Yeah, see that big robot over there? We gotta take it out next. Look at that, it's already firing at me and I'm not even off the pathway yet. Fuck you! And we destroyed each other. Come on. Stop hopping all over the wreckage of your... There we go. Okay. Now, okay. This, I'm pretty sure, is what leads me to the area I was thinking about before. Yeah, this place. I thought I was in the basement. But there's a ton of monkeys in this room. See that fan? That is a very strong fan that will blow you off if you even so much as think of jumping while on any platforms in front of it. So, let's see. Let me destroy this thing over here. Yeah, see how much that screen shaked? Yeah, now we can shoot that button. That makes that platform stretch out above us. Hi-ya. 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 Okay. Now, how this works is... you're supposed to... No. Hold on. I'm not done explaining. Okay. Whenever you're stepping on this platform, whenever you're standing on it, it will slowly lower until you get to the fan that will blow you off. You need to use the RC car to control the platform. Putting it on the button will make it rise. Moving it off of the button will make it fall. And you gotta catch these monkeys by jumping at them like this. Okay? On the button. See? I'm getting pushed away. Okay. Now. What we just did was we just opened up a huge gate that was blocking this window here. But I can't destroy it from this angle. Too much shit in the way. So let me move this RC car. Okay. Move the RC car back off. Oh, no, back onto it. I mean, oh god. I can't. I'm gonna die. Because I can't get onto this button. It's gonna blow me off. That's the danger. That's the danger of that platform. That fucking fan. Our goal was to turn that fan off. Because there's a monkey at the bottom that we can't catch for as long as it's on. So let's get the Skyflyer. And jump right into here. Ignoring the whims of the fan. Do something else. Really? There we go. Now, what you gotta do, and what most people don't know you gotta do, for the first time they play this game, is you gotta destroy these computers. And that shuts the fan down. See how quiet it got? Okay, now you can climb these stairs to get back up. Now, the fan isn't completely shut off. It's still blowing some wind. So you still gotta be careful. Let me just, get my RC car on this now so that I can command it to take me back up when I'm done. Now just wait for it to take me all the way down to the bottom. Yeah, you see it's still pushing me slightly? That means that jumping is still a bad idea. Okay, got that one. Now I'll move the RC car back onto the button. Then take us all the way back up. Don't let it push you off still. Okay. Now we can get out of here. This big old optional area filled with monkeys. I say optional, but actually I'll talk about that when the time comes. Okay, how many monkeys is that? All but one. All but that one monkey out in the front. But I also missed a Spectre coin somewhere. Where was it? I forget where. I'm gonna have to look for it when I come back here for the last monkey. Really? Well, anyway, I'm out of time. A little bit over time. I didn't realize how over time I was. But, next time we pick up, I will be standing in front of that elevator that I showed you before. The one that will take us up to the last area of this level. And then we'll move on from there. The one after this is a big stage. In fact, I can probably get to the credits in the next episode. We'll see. So, thank you all so very much for watching. If you liked this episode, leave a like. Every like means a lot to me. And if you want to be notified whenever I upload more videos, subscribe, and you will. And if you want to support me on Patreon, you can. There'll be a link in the annotations at the end of the video and in the description below. So, I'll see you all in the next video. Out of the way, bat. Out of the way, bat. Are you kidding me? You went left. Get out of my... Oh my god.